Hello everyone, welcome to Educare 247. This is the 27th lecture in our special revision series for SEBI Grade A exams. In this lecture, we will be discussing MCQs on the history of banking system in India. Banking system in India is a part of syllabus of finance. It comes under the heading Financial Systems in India. So now with the first question. Question number one. The first bank established in India was A. Bank of India, B. Bank of Hindustan, C. General Bank of India, or D. State Bank of India. So the answer here is B. Bank of Hindustan. So the first bank in India, the first is the Bank of Hindustan, established in 1770. This bank was established at Calcutta under European management. It was liquidated in 1830 to 1832. So it was established in 1770 and liquidated in 1830-1832. Question number two. The largest and oldest bank still in existence in India is A. Punjab National Bank, B. Reserve Bank of India, C. State Bank of India, or D. Imperial Bank. So the answer here is C. State Bank of India. So now let us look at the history of State Bank of India. See, from 1612 onwards, the British East India Company had set up various factories or trading posts in India with the permission of local Mughal emperors. In this process, they had established three presidency towns. So what were the three presidency towns? First, Madras, then Bombay and Bengal Presidency. Three presidency banks were set up for each town. So first they set up the three presidency towns, right? And the bank was required in each town. So they set up three presidency banks, which were called the Bank of Calcutta, Bank of Bombay, and Bank of Madras. In 1921, the three presidency banks, the Bank of Bengal, Bank of Bombay, and Bank of Madras, were amalgamated to form the Imperial Bank of India. It was a private entity till that time. Then in 1955, this Imperial Bank of India was nationalized and renamed as the State Bank of India. So the previous name of State Bank of India was the Imperial Bank of India, and it was formed by amalgamating three presidency banks: Banks of Bengal, Bank of Bombay, and Bank of Madras. Thus, the State Bank of India is the oldest bank of India among the banks that exist today. So the largest and oldest bank still in existence is the State Bank of India. Educare offers various courses for SEBI Grade A exams. We have comprehensive courses for SEBI Grade A 2020, which includes syllabus of both paper 1 and 2. Then we have MCQ courses for SEBI Grade A 2020 for paper 2, and we also have SEBI Grade A 2020 crash course for phase 1 and 2. You can apply with coupon code SEBI, SEBI, and avail discounts on comprehensive courses and crash courses. However, since the MCQ courses are already at a discounted price, no further discount is available in this course. So you can enroll on these various courses on the basis of your preparation stage. Move on to question number 3. How many banks were nationalized on 19th July 1969? So were they 15 banks, 13 banks, 14 banks, or 16 banks? So the answer is C. 14 banks were nationalized on 19th July 1969. So let us again go back into history and look at the nationalization of banks in India. The banking sector reform started immediately after independence. These reforms were basically aimed at improving the confidence level of public, because in those days, most banks were not trusted by majority of the public. The first major step was nationalization of the Imperial Bank of India in 1955 via the State Bank India Act. Right. So Imperial Bank was the previous name of State Bank of India was Imperial Bank, right? So the first major step was the nationalization of Imperial Bank. After that, In a major process of nationalization, 7 subsidiaries of the State Bank of India were nationalized via the State Bank of India Subsidiary Bank Act. So first the State Bank was nationalized, then the subsidiaries, 7 subsidiaries of State Bank was also nationalized. Then in 1969, 14 major private commercial banks were nationalized. So this is what the question is asking, right? In 19th July 1969, how many banks were nationalized? So the answer is 14. Then the above was followed by a second phase of nationalization in 1980, when the government of India acquired the ownership of 6 more banks, thus bringing the total number of nationalized banks to 20. So in 1969, 14 major private commercial banks were nationalized. Then this was followed by nationalization of 6 more banks in 1980. So total banks to be nationalized were 20. Moving on to question number 4. The liberalization of the Indian banking and regulation was done based on the recommendation of A. R. Gandhi Committee, B. Narasimham Committee, C. Basel Committee, or D. Khusro Committee. So the answer here is B. Narasimham Committee. The Narasimham Committee was established under former RBI Governor M. Narasimham in August 1991 to look into all aspects of financial system in India. The report of this committee had comprehensive recommendations for financial sector reforms, including Indian banking sector and capital markets. Question number 5. Oath Commercial Bank was founded in the year 1913, 1917, 1894 or 1881. See, now why is the establishment of Oath Commercial Bank important? Because Oath Commercial Bank was the first limited liability bank in India to be managed by the Indian Board of Directors. That's why Oath Commercial Bank is significant for us, right? So the answer here is D, 1881. The first bank with limited liability to be managed by Indian Board was Oath Commercial Bank. It was established in 1881 at Faizabad. However, the bank failed. It did not last long and it failed in 1958. It was liquidated in 1958. Then the first bank purely managed by Indians was the Punjab National Bank, established in Lahore, 1895. The Punjab National Bank has not only survived till date, but also is one of the largest bank in India. However, the first Indian commercial bank which was wholly owned and managed by Indians was the Central Bank of India, which was established in 1911. So Central Bank of India is also called India's first truly Swadeshi bank. So we studied about 3 banks here, right? First, the Oath Commercial Bank. It is important because it is the first bank with limited liability to be managed by Indian Board. Then the Punjab National Bank. It is important because it was the first bank purely managed by Indians, right? Then we have the Central Bank, which is also called the first truly Swadeshi bank because it was wholly owned and managed by Indians. We've come to the end of the video. If you found the video useful, then do like and share the video and stay tuned to the channel for more videos on different topics for SEBI Grade A exams. Thank you.